You're watching UNICEF television. 15-year-old Mohamed Axam Maumoon from Maldives is one of the 160 climate ambassadors who participated in the Children Climate Change Forum. Axam spoke at the panel discussion in Copenhagen, reaffirming the urgency for world leaders to act.
As I try to convey our message to you, I am not alone. I am among 164 delegates from 44 countries representing more than 2.5 billion citizens most vulnerable to catastrophic climate change. The voices, the concerns, and the pain of all the children of the world ring true in my heart. My eyes go moist, not when I watch a movie, no, not when I lose a football game, and certainly not when I gave away my toys, but because I understand how it feels to see my future so clearly, just within my grasp, and be forced to let it go. Believe me, I didn't want this to happen. In simple words, we are now in the era of climate injustice. In Maldives, where I come from, people are worried and they want to see change. We are only 1 meter above sea level. But we have survived on our tiny 1,997 islands for more than 2,500 years. And every day, meter by meter of land just washes out to sea, sometimes plucking out houses with people still in them. Being heard and listened to is a basic right for children as well, I have read. And so I urge you all, even those who already do listen, to pay more attention and give us more support than before. Because we are not only talking about your future or ours alone. We are talking about the futures or even the beginnings for countless generations to come. We, the children of the world, me especially, are very deeply saddened to know that the world leaders had not been able to come to a fair, legally binding treaty before. And this treaty should put an end to the excruciating pain felt by the children of today. Hold hands, work together, and don't hesitate to share. That's my advice to all the world leaders today. And we believe that by working together, as one huge body, we'll prevent more mistakes, such as this acceleration of climate change that we face today. And if there's still more people who don't think that climate change is such a big issue, believe me, there are some people. If there are these kind of people, I would ask them one question. Would you commit murder? Even though you know that it's wrong, even though you know that the victim begs for mercy, would you do that? No. But it's the same that these people are doing to us if you don't make any change. Because letting us suffer for what we suffer is as bad as killing us off, not to mention making small children, like your very own, starve. Since the future is for the children, you must first think about this. How old would your children be in 2050? Would they be able to see what we have seen? Would they be able to experience the wonderful life that we are really living right now? Would they? But we are late, but we are not too late. This is the best time to act, and the best time is now. Thank you. I'm Mohamed Maumoon from the Maldives, representing and carrying all the voices of all the children of the world, including your own. Thank you.
You've been watching UNICEF television. To learn more, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.